Information is stored in data blocks. Each data block is created for a unique combination of sparse dimension members and holds values for the members of a dense dimension. For example, if you have three sparse dimensions with two members in each dimension, eight unique combinations of sparse dimension members can be generated. The combinations of sparse members are also known as indexes. Each of these combinations can point to a potential data block in a dense dimension member. A data block is not created unless information for an index is available. Data blocks are created when data is loaded using forms and other input options. However, when a custom calculation that writes to a data cell is executed, a corresponding data block must exist. If a data block doesn't exist, you need to create it for the data to be returned to the database. The best way to create data blocks for custom calculation is to fix on a sparse member, write to a dense member, and make sure that the source has data. Here, we fix on sparse members, anchor on the sparse member FCCS other data, and write to the dense member inventory stock. Ensure that the expression uses data blocks and results into data that can be returned to the dense member. Here, the bottom-up execution mode is used for best performance. If you fix or anchor on a dense member as shown here, the system will perform the calculation, but the block to store the result of the calculation will not be created. The result will only be stored if the corresponding block exists before running the calculation. The size of a block is determined by the number of members in a dense dimension. For example, the block size of a dense dimension with two members is 16 bytes, as each member is allocated 8 bytes. You can also create a block from a form by entering 0 in a dense member input field and saving the form. The value in the corresponding block can later be replaced with relevant data. In addition, you can use the following methods to create blocks for custom calculations: data load, create block API, sbase data copy command. Creating a data block by using data load, the create block API, or sbase data copy command must be used cautiously, as these methods may create unnecessary blocks and slow down the consolidation process. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.